IPv4, IPv6, static, dynamic. Who understands IP addressing? I do. I'm gonna make sure you do as soon as we get done talking. All that and more coming up now. Hello, everybody. Welcome back. My name is Adam Gordon, an entertainer here at IT Pro TV, coming at you with another fun-filled and exciting episode of What Can You Do with Server 2019, Server 2016, and or Server 2022. Well, you can do lots of stuff. And in this series, we show you how to do common tasks, things that you're probably scratching your head about and often wonder about. Everybody else knows how to do them. Why don't I? It's because you and I haven't spent time together yet. In this episode, we're going to take a look at how you can understand what kind of IP address your system is using. Is it an IPv4 or an IPv6 address? And equally importantly, is it static, assigned manually and configured so it doesn't change? Or is it dynamic, assigned automatically through what we call DHCP, the Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol, and essentially rotates and potentially changes over time, keeping your system connected, but allowing your system to essentially pull an IP address out of a pool and lease one as opposed to owning one when it's static. We're going to take a look at all that and make sure you understand what's going on there. Join me here if you will. We're going to be able to do this across Server 2016, Server 2019, and or Server 2022. In this particular episode, I'm going to do this on Server 2022. It's become available. It's something people are using, something you very well may have deployed. And the good news is, no matter what version of server you're running, what we're about to show you how to do, the tools we use, the approaches we encourage you to think about using, all of that's the same regardless of the version you're running. And so whether you're on 16, 19, or 2022, you can use PowerShell, as I'm about to show you. You can use through the network configuration in Control Panel and seeing the properties of the IP address based on their binding to a network card. You can see all of that in the same way, using the same tools, going to the same places, none of it's gonna change. Now I'm gonna show you two ways we can tell what kind of IP address you have, IPv4 or IPv6. You'll find often you have both. And I'm gonna show you not only how to do that, but I'm gonna show you that we can then decide and understand whether it's static or dynamic. And we can do all that from the command line, as well as doing that from within the graphical interface. We'll jump in and begin by taking a look at the command line, in this case, PowerShell. If you don't remember or don't understand where to find PowerShell, you can go to your start menu, and you'll find that depending on the version of PowerShell you have installed, the default version that comes with and is installed by default on the server, the older version, version 5X, will be right here, the square I'm pointing to under the Windows Server area. If you've installed a newer version, like PowerShell 7 as I have, we'll see it in the start menu. You can always go down here to the Windows PowerShell folder and see your versions of PowerShell installed and access them right from there, and or the new version up under PowerShell there as well. We're going to use the new version PowerShell 7 to be able to do this demonstration, as I often remind you to do when we talk about the use of PowerShell. Right-clicking and starting it by running as administrator is going to give you maximum flexibility as you use PowerShell and give you rights to do most, if not all, of the things that we're talking about without having to worry about changing out your session or upgrading your credential or being prompted or anything like that. So I've gone ahead and I've already started up PowerShell. It's running as an administrator, as you can see right up at the top there. And I've issued a very straightforward command called the ipconfig command, short for IP configuration. And I've added the /all switch at the end of it to see the complete list of the configuration, as opposed to a truncated, shortened version that doesn't give me all the information I'm looking for. And in the case of understanding which kind of IP address or addresses do I have, IPv4 and or IPv6, and what's the status of that IP address, is it static or dynamic, this information will all be found through the IP configuration output that we get with this command. So it's very simple to do. Now you can actually run the same command from the Windows command line. You don't have to use PowerShell because this is a Windows command. It has nothing to do with PowerShell. But the nice thing about PowerShell is that it will run any and all commandlets, whether they're PowerShell centric or not, as long as that command exists in Windows and it's available to PowerShell, it will execute. And so I don't have to put in the ipconfig and the path and all that to tell it where to find it. PowerShell knows and it believes when I type it that it's legitimate. It checks, and if it is, goes ahead and executes for me with no trouble. So ipconfig is a standard networking command that we use, shows us the configuration of the system, and when we add the all switch, it allows us to see everything we want to see. Now, when I scroll down here beyond just the basic stuff about the name of the machine and some information that, for our purposes in this conversation, is not all that critical, we get to see the Ethernet adapter information, which tells us what the network interface in our machine is configured as or how it is configured. I could see that it is a Hyper-V network adapter. I said I'm running a Windows virtual machine using Server 2022, so that makes sense. I can see, in this case, that these two lines right here, DHCP enabled, auto configuration enabled, implies that I have a dynamic address. I'm getting it through the DHCP system. Dynamic host configuration protocol is used to allow a pool of addresses to be made available to machines and allows those machines to come in and grab one for a predetermined period of time. That period of time is going to be available to us right here under the lease obtained, lease expires area. And that means that for this duration, and we can see the information about it right there, from Friday, September 10th, 2021, at approximately 6:47 a.m. to Saturday, September 11th, 2021, roughly 24 hours later, you could see that lease is available. I've got that IP address. It's good for 1 day or approximately 24 hours, according to the current configuration. So I can see that it is dynamic. It is not static. And I can see that the address of the DHCP server that's giving me that dynamic information, that dynamic IP address, is right there. And I can also see, if I choose to, right up here, what my actual IPv4 address is. That is my IPv4 address, IP version 4 for IPv4. And although I do potentially have a DHCP system, or I can, I should say, have a DHCP system that may hand out IPv6 addresses, I may or may not have one. And so right now I don't see an IPv6 address. I simply see a link local IPv6 address right there, which is an address that is available for me to do certain things with the system, but it's not an IPv6 address that I would normally use to communicate with other systems across the internet, for instance, or something like that. And so we do see that we're running an IPv4 solution, and we see evidence of that just by looking at the configuration. So it's easy to check if we know what to look for, but we can also do this through the graphical interface. Let's minimize PowerShell. Let's open up the graphical interface to see the same information using the properties of the network card, in this case, our Ethernet adapter. So I'm going to right click on this little icon right down here at the bottom where I'm hovering, where it says network internet access. That's going to be my network card. And I'm going to choose to go in and I'm going to choose to open network and internet settings for my little pop-up menu down there. And that's going to bring up the control panel and show me the settings. Currently, the status is where I am right over here of my connection. I'm connected out to the internet, as you can see. And if I come down here under advanced network settings, I'm going to come over here to where it says change adapter options. I'm going to click on that. It's going to open up what may be familiar to many of you. If you've used to working with older systems, you will see that this is the traditional, you know, earlier, let's say back in like Windows 7 days and Windows Vista, let's say Server 2000, maybe 2008, 2012. If you know about older operating systems, you'd probably be used to looking in the control panel and seeing your internet connection and your Ethernet cards represented using older icons like this. And so this is my Ethernet connection. This is my network card. And I can right click on it and I can choose to look at the properties and notice a little blue and yellow shield that is to the left of properties. That is going to allow me to open this with administrative capabilities and administrative rights. And that means that I'll have ability to be able to modify, look at what's currently there, but also modify and make changes to those settings if necessary. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and open this up. I'm looking at the properties of the network connection of the Ethernet card. And I've got a bunch of different options here. Really only one interests us. It's the fourth option down. It says Internet Protocol version 4, IPv4, as you can see, and or Internet Protocol version 6. So I can check the status of either or both of those network interface, the network interface, one or both of those addresses that are assigned in order to be able to, it's hard to keep all those words straight in your mouth. I can check the status of that to make sure that I see whether I do indeed have an IPv4, an IPv6, one or both addresses assigned. So I'm going to highlight the IPv4 one. We're going to go ahead and double click. Double clicking, by the way, is the same thing as highlighting And although I didn't choose to do this, clicking the properties button at the lower right-hand corner there, it does the same thing. And when I do that, you could see that I'm able to see the properties. In this case, on the general tab, I could see that I'm currently set to obtain an IP address automatically. Let's just zoom in so you can see that. And what that means is that I'm using DHCP, as we already saw evidence of in PowerShell, and I'm getting that IP address assigned to me automatically. I don't see all the information about how long the lease is for, what the actual IP address is. I would have to use a command line to find that information, but I've already shown you how to do that. But I can check the status of the IP address assignment and figure out easily whether it is indeed a DHCP-driven address, dynamic, D for DHCP, D for dynamic, or it is static. And if I choose the other option, use the following IP address, I could type in the IP address here very easily just by going, doing this, and then putting in the appropriate IP address, 10.0.0.9, or whatever the case may be, along with the appropriate subnet mask and or default gateway. And I could also specify my DNS servers if I need to as well for name resolution, internet access, things like that. As long as I have the right IP address information, the right subnet, and the right IP address block for use on whatever network I want to connect to, I can, if I have permission and a need, assign my own static IP address, provided I pay attention to the following rule. It must be unique, meaning someone else cannot already be using this IP address anywhere in my network, or I'll have a conflict, and an IP address conflict implies both machines will not be able to send or receive until we change that IP address out on one of them, getting rid of that conflict that's causing the inability to transmit. So we have to be careful about setting these addresses and know what we're doing, but I could easily do a static IP address or engage in a static IP address assignment simply by modifying the properties right here. I can leave it as the default, which is the dynamic address, just by leaving everything that we saw intact. Oh, and one other thing. Just go back in. I forgot to show you. I could do the same thing with IPv6 right down here. It looks the same in the sense that ultimately the window looks the same. The only difference is that it is a little bit longer for the entry field because IPv6 addresses are longer overall. They are 128 bits as opposed to 32 bits, so typing them out takes more space. But you'll see by default, we are obtaining those addresses automatically if they are available through a DHCP server. And again, if we want to use a static assignment, just simply toggle that with the radio button, type in the appropriate address in the appropriate manner, meaning again, know that I have the right network address, right subnet block, and the right address as well. And once I've done all that and put all that information in and I apply it, I'll have a static IP address as opposed to dynamic if I choose to. All right, so we're gonna cancel out of here, cancel out of here, cancel out of here, get out of here, get back to our screen. Now, if you just want to go ahead, and let's just clear this for just one second. If you just want to see what ipconfig does without the ipconfig all, you'll see it does tell us just the bare minimum information that we need to know. It tells us that we do have an IPv4 address. It does tell us that that is available, but it doesn't tell us whether it's coming to us from DHCP or whether it's static. If I want to see that information, I have to do ipconfig all. Getting that full configuration information is going to be important. And as I suggested to you, we can do this from the command line. Just one last thing I'll show you quickly before we wrap up. And we can do that right from here. If we do cmd, so the Windows command line, which is our old, probably one of our oldest tools in Windows. It's been around forever. Notice I launched it as an administrator, so I don't have to worry about having permission to do this. And I'm just gonna go ahead and make it a little bit easier for us to see that. We'll bump that font up and make that a 20 point so it looks kind of like it did in PowerShell. And if I type ipconfig, I get the same information we just saw. And if I type ipconfig/all, I get the same information we just saw in PowerShell. As I said, PowerShell will execute the ipconfig command with no trouble. And we can do this from either of those interfaces. So two command line options, one graphical option gives us either individually or in a combined way, the opportunity to understand what versioning of IP address we may be running, V4 and or V6, and tells us whether it is a static or a dynamic assignment. And if it is dynamic, points to the DHCP server that is giving out those addresses. We may or may not have control of it and visibility into it directly. Maybe, in other words, someone else in the organization that's managing that, but at least we know that we're using a DHCP sponsored or dynamic address. And then if we choose to make it static, we have options to do that as well. So this is how we can optimize your understanding of just the basics around IP addresses. A lot more to know about that. But if you're interested in finding out more about it, you can always join me over at IT Pro TV. We teach you how to understand IP addresses and thousands of other things that come in handy, not only for you in your private life, working with your computers at home, but in business every day as an IT professional, working with systems and maintaining them. We're the place you can get all that information. And we're always creating new content, just like this episode and this series. And we're always putting it together and making it available for you. All you need to do, stop by and hang out with me and spend some time. And well, I'm going to show you all sorts of cool stuff. We're going to call this episode done for now. I'm going to wish you happy servering, and I'll see you soon.